As we see from these gospel readings how the church mother of our faith, as she is preparing us gradually but accurately for the great events that will take place towards the end, of course, of this week, because we're living in the holy and sacred week we called Holy Week. And thus we see how in this particular narrative, Jesus is speaking about his coming death and about his betrayal at the hands of Judas. And we see here that our blessed Lord also says, "Now is the Son of Man glorified, and God is glorified in him." All of this refers, of course, to the fact that our blessed Savior, by accepting in profound and deep obedience the will of God the Father in his life, of allowing himself to be crucified, immolated, and dying on the cross for us, God will not only achieve for us through the Jesus, our Savior, salvation and redemption and reconciliation with him, but also God the Father will glorify Jesus in his human nature and will rise him from the dead. So all of this is a preparation that Jesus is saying to the apostles on the very night of his betrayal, that although he will have to pass through a great moment of travail, ultimately this will all end in great glory and glorification in the great feast of Easter. So my dearest friends, as we continue to prepare ourselves for Holy Thursday and Good Friday, let's see these great moments in the life of Jesus within the mindset and within the perspective of what Jesus himself says of his glorification, of his resurrection. We can never understand Holy Week if we don't ultimately see it culminated in the resurrection. As many of the church fathers used to say and write, we are Easter Christians. We are not Good Friday Christians. You know, traditionally in some countries throughout the centuries in the past, until the Vatican Council II, when we once again rediscovered the tremendous importance of the resurrection, well, there was so much emphasis on Good Friday. There was so much excessive emphasis on the death of Jesus that almost to a certain point it overlooked the culmination of the passion and death of Jesus in the resurrection, almost overlooked the resurrection, to the point that many Christians were just Good Friday Christians and didn't see great importance in the resurrection of Easter Sunday. One of the great events, one of the great aspects, actually, of Vatican Council II has been the rediscovery of the tremendous importance of Easter. Easter, more than Christmas, more than any other feast day throughout the year, is the most important feast. Speaking to some people about the importance of the second Sunday of Easter and Divine Mercy Sunday, there is a tendency also among some people, mistakenly, to put the second Sunday of Easter, Divine Mercy Sunday, almost on the same level of Easter. And that is absolutely and completely wrong. Divine mercy flows forth from the glory of Easter. Nothing can be on the same level as Easter. Easter is the greatest of all of our feasts. And therefore, that's why it's very important, as we continue to repeat myself, as we continue to prepare ourselves for Holy Thursday and Good Friday, always remember this is the interval before the great culmination of the glory of the resurrection of Jesus in his triumph over death. Because it's in his resurrection that his sacrifice on the cross and his passion has been accepted by God the Father. It's an acceptance of his immolation on the cross, which is truly the resurrection. And not only that, in the resurrection of Jesus, we have already the foreshadowing and the predicting of what we will experience personally in our own lives. If we have been faithful to Jesus throughout our personal lives, when we die, our spirits will go to God. And in the end of the world, in the second judgment, our bodies glorified, united with our spirits, will enjoy forever the resurrection of the living and of the dead. So, my dearest friends, remember always that as we prepare ourselves for these days, let us share the glory of Easter with a wonderful feast, by visiting our friends, by having our family members come together, by eating, of course, not getting drunk, of course, by eating and drinking and having a good time, but by dancing, but always in a measured and Christian manner, of course, celebrating the glory of Jesus in the resurrection. In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen.
Espíritu Santo, descienda sobre nosotros. Amén.